You can start recording. I think okay. So students, now mock number 3. Let's develop the answer. Again, mock number 3, you all have done very well. Structuring was good, everyone. But the only problem was the application. The application was an issue. Other than that, the structuring was extremely good. So before I start doing this mock number 3, I just want to take the pre-seen material and I need to clarify this, students. Now, if you see here, you see this dotted line. Do you see this dotted line coming here? That means Jack Cavery, the chairman, is a member of all three committees. He's a member of all three committees. And Marco Palomo is a member of risk committee. See, the red color line goes to risk committee and audit committee. So he is heading these two. And if you see Juliana Ling, and she is also handling the audit committee and the remuneration committee. And if you see Patrick Chi, he is handling the remuneration committee and the risk committee. So students, all these committees eventually has three members. How many members, students? Three members. So this is how we identify the people who are in charge in each committees, but the only problem is we do not have a nomination committee till now. We do not have a nomination committee till now. Okay, so students, let's go through this. Pat Oily has sent you the following mail. The new factory which we started in the D-Land for recycling purpose had the following issue. As per the understanding, we have observed that some managers are overstating the invoices with the help of the support staff. Therefore, we are paying them more than for what it would actually cost, and we have identified the process reconciliation. Please be kind enough to respond on the following. Firstly, explain the board how we can make the internal control very robust in order to prevent fraud in the future. Okay. And secondly, this fraud should come into the light. So in the future, members will not commit the same fraud in the future. Please discuss how you will be able to guide our internal audit team in developing good audit process. Okay, one is audit process and one is how to develop a robust audit function, okay, to prevent fraud. So students, now generally, if you come to this case study, it is practical application. And here we have started the factory in the D-Land for recycling purpose. So the first thing I can say, it's a 40% and this is 60%. 40% and 60%. 40% and 60%. So 40%, I'll start working with the framing first. So framing, so I'll just mention the part A is 40%. So 40% means it's 10 marks, students. And then the part B is 60%. It's how many percent, students? 60%, 60% means it is 15 marks. So students, the first area is explain the board how we can make the internal control very robust. So I'll write here, okay, internal control. Oh, I'll write down a heading as making, or I can say developing a robust internal control. Developing a robust internal control. Robust internal control. Robust internal control. Robust internal control. Robust means strong. Robust means strong. So developing a robust internal control. So students, below that we can write down a small sentence. I can say generally the internal control of an organization is developed to control the risk and improve the organization performance. Improve the organization, what, students? Performance. Increase the organization performance. So that's a basic explanation of internal control system. So students, I can generally say here, one way of developing the internal control is centralizing the finance function, centralizing the what function, students? Finance function, centralizing the finance function. Now, students, at the moment, the finance function is not centralized. What generally happens is the factory managers are the people who can overstate and understate. But if you centralize the finance function, what happens is the central, that is the group only, will be taking care of the finance function. So the invoice changing will not affect. So students, any questions you have in the centralizing, so what I will do is I will continue with the explanation on centralizing the finance function. So students who just joined now, I have given you the recording functions so that you can record the video also. So I can say centralizing is having one power of authority on a particular function, one power of authority in a particular function. Centralizing is having one power of authority in a centralized in a particular function. Okay, so I can generally come to the point. Okay, so I can say at present, so I'll come to the business application. At present, the finance function is decentralized to the recycling plant in Dillon. In which country? In Dillon. However, if the finance function is centralized, then there will be proper control over the invoicing. Just keep in mind, students, proper control over the invoicing. So students, I can just continue with the people application. So I can generally mention as geo patron, that is the CFO. Geo patron can be responsible for integrating the finance function to one common platform. So students, I will just go through the present material now and just see about our finance function. How is our finance function carried out? So students, at the moment, did they give any information about our finance function? Let's just check and see our finance function. They have just given about how it works out, but just check whether do we have anything related to our finance function. Let's see, management reporting finance function, page number. Can someone tell me page number? It's good, thank you very much. Page number. Page number, anyone can support with the page number? So here the risk impact is given, internal auditor's report is given. Organizational chart. Okay, if you look at the organizational charge, management accounting, financial reporting and treasury, but they have not given much information about it. So I can generally say, so integrating is very crucial, because I was thinking whether they have given any existing softwares they are using for finance function. So integrating is a very important thing that we can keep in mind, students. So thank you very much for that support what you gave here. Okay, so students, common platform. So I can just continue this. the management with the support of non-executive directors could plan on investing in a cloud platform for finance therefore there can be proper control over the invoice in the future proper control over the invoice in the future so students any questions there I think there is no questions there so it looks fine so students that is one thing what I was saying centralizing so that is very important so students any other thing students that is a very important point so if we centralize it at the moment there is high chances that the internal control will be strong here so that looks very good here when we are doing this so another thing students I can generally say like you all have written I do say you all have written a good answer but the answer is very much technical so I can just mention here segregation of duties segregation of what duties segregation of duties so students I'll just write a small intro on black color ink so segregation of duty is generally providing the company to have a division of labor and a division of labor and a labor authority and approval which is segregated rather than being one person control so students I'll just continue here so I can say at present the internal control is poor in deal and factory mainly because the company is only having the functions delegated to the manager rather than a process where there is some other staff to verify and approve the transaction. So I can just mention example, the factory accountant can be vested with some authority for the invoices prepared by the manager. Come on. So I can continue here. I can say this will generally increase, this will generally increase, it will generally increase the transparency, of the process, and it will minimize, the fraud. So that is one more function that we can generally think about it. So students, that is a one good point. And one thing, students, now if you have seen this internal audit charter, they are clearly mentioning here that in this page, I think page number 15, Marco Palermo is the person who is in charge for risk and what, audit committee. So just keep in mind, okay, Marco Palermo is a very important person who is in charge. So just keep in mind, students, they have clearly mentioned at the moment the audit committee is having some delegation of control. So that looks fine at the moment. So one is segregation of duty, other one is known as the centralization. So another thing I can generally say here in this practical scenario, so I can say here as spot checks and regular internal audit reviews, spot checks and regular internal audit reviews. So students, at the moment they do not have any spot checks. They were able to understand this is when the group accounting was reconciled. Other than that, there were nothing special items here to understand what has happened. So students, I can just mention spot checks and regular audit review. So I can just say that spot check can be done. Spot check can be done at an unexpected situation where the internal audit team visit the factory and review the invoices and the processing Come on, I will continue here. So I can generally say with a red color pen. So I can say Marco. I'll come to Marco a little later. So I can generally say at present, the fraud has been identified. Only when the company was reconciling the group accounts. If there have been a spot check on a regular basis, there may be less chances that the manager would have committed fraud. Okay. So students, just keep in mind committed fraud. Okay, so I can continue. I can say Marco, correct? So I think it's Marco can guide the chief internal auditor on developing a process reviewing the developing the process of reviewing the invoices in the factory by having spot checks. This needs to be approved by the senior management and well documented before the process is implemented. So I will also put the leadership thing, so I can say this will enhance the ethical responsibility within the firm on professional behavior and professional competence, professional behavior and professional competence. So that is the next point. So students, now spot checks and regular internal audit review. So that is the third one. And one more thing I can say, whistleblowing. One more thing I can say, whistleblowing. So students, this is also one more thing that we can do, because it's a new factory. So when it's a factory is new, what will happen is people will be not so much comfortable to tell these things to the management, because they will be very much closer to the manager rather than to the management. So I can write down here, whistleblowing is the situation where the employees raise concerns of some unauthorized activities taking place in the organization. So I can continue this. So this is the most important thing. So I'll just mention one more person who is in charge. So I can say Juliana. So before moving into Juliana, I can say the whistleblowing culture should be developed from the top management tone. So comma and I'll continue. I can generally say here as Juliana can visit the factory, and have a general meeting and explain the ethical responsibility and professional due care of the employees and guide them to whistleblow if there is any fraud situations. Come on. So I will continue here. So I can say this will enhance the respect and loyalty towards the organization. Because the company will have a strong relationship with all the level of employees, full stop. So students, these are the four major points I think I have developed on the first area. 2.5 marks I am assuming. So if these things are there, students, I think the system will be a little robust. Now students, the issue is you have, but the question is, have you applied the spam soap? That is the question. You have written the spam soap, have you applied the spam soap? That is the question. So before we go into the part B requirement, students, if you have any questions, can you please feel, let me know so that I can explain it in detail.
Mr. Ranufel Kirania, just one question. So on the second point you, or the first point you mentioned about the finance function centralization, right? So the managers, whom are we talking about here when we say managers?
The manager in DLAN.
So he's not the finance manager.
No.
He's the operations manager.
Operation manager. So what has happened is they are given full responsibility towards him because it's a new factory. So
yeah.
Because of that, what he's doing is he is starting to overstate the invoices and get additional finance. So
right.
If we centralize it, what happens is he will not have the authority of developing or charging the finances. So he will just be a monitoring person. So that is the meaning on centralizing.
Okay, because the second point, segregation of duties, we are saying that we will give some control to the accountant
factory
in the
accountant.
Branch, factory
accountant.
Accountant.
But at the moment here, the factory accountant is just used to do the costing identity. But manager has given the full responsibility. Even though they have not mentioned factory accountant here, I'm assuming there is a factory accountant. That is my own point.
Hmm. So in that case, the in billing will be, or the invoicing will be done by the manager, but then it will be vetted by the accountant. That is
accountant,
our proposal.
Accountant, and they will check and see whether is he inflating or not inflating. So there will be some control. At least, because if around three people are doing the finance, the risk is little less because the amount must tally everything. But if only one person is doing the finance, it will be cost saving. But the problem is he can take over the power of having so much thing, and he will use it for his personal benefit.
Right. No, I was only thinking, okay, even if you centralize the finance function, and then if the invoice continues to be raised by the manager, the only thing is that, okay, approval will have to be done by the centralized function.
Centralized function. But my concern here is, Mr. Kiran, the centralization of finance function means even the invoices also will be raised by the senior management. That is the central division. And even the everything is done by the central finance function. That is in GLAN.
Hmm. Okay.
Friends,
okay.
Any other questions? Any other questions? Okay, I think that is fine. But the only problem is, students, in the next mock exam, can you please use the color coding? In the next mock exam, please use the color coding, students, for the time being. Because, students, if you are not using the color coding, what generally happens is, students, you will become completely writing something in a different angle, and you will focus mostly on the technical areas. So students, secondly, this fraud should come into light. So in the future, other members will not commit the same fraud. Please discuss how we will be able to guide our internal audit team in developing a good audit process. So students, I'll write down here, okay? Developing a good audit process, developing a good audit, what students? Process. So let's start working here, developing a good audit process. So the first thing I'm going to mention is recruit experienced staff, recruit experienced staff. So students, this is a very important point when you are developing a good audit process. The main reason is in D-Land, in country D-Land, we are going for the first time expansion. So it's better to have experienced staff in the audit so that they will know how the international market is functioning and they can help you on how to develop a good audit process in this region. So I can generally say for audit, the experienced employees or experienced auditors will be a strength. Just I'm writing. It will be very good strength. Okay, so I can continue here. You can say, this is our first international expansion. Therefore, we need to be very much careful when developing the audit process. In the recycling factory. Comma. So I can comma and I can continue with a different color pen. I can write down, Marco could consult the chief internal auditor. Marco can consult the chief internal auditor, okay, and he can further decide on how to employ some auditors with good experience in the recycling sector. Come on. So students, just keep in mind in the recycling sector. Okay, in the recycling sector. So I will further continue, students. I can say, when the staffs are experienced and the staffs are well experienced, the professional due care will be at the highest standard. Will be at the highest standard. Comma. And Since Runabout is a listed company, we will not be having a reputational risk in the future because of experienced auditors, even though the cost may be higher. Full stop. So students, in the first audit process, you should always go for recruit experienced staff students, because this is the first operation what you are going. So there should be very much experienced staff in this. So students, any questions in this you can ask. Okay, so the next one I will write is, so I'll write down the next one. Define the objective of an audit. Well, the students, there should be a purpose of audit. You should tell it to the employee. The objective of audit, the objective of audit is to ensure that the stewardship function, that the stewardship function is carried out efficiently and effectively. Efficiently and what, students? Effectively. Efficiently and effectively. So I will continue, students, the next point. So I can say the company is currently having good stewardship function in Geeland. However, we need to develop in D-Land too. Since the operations are different, from Geeland and D-Land, the same audit objective cannot be used because it's a factory. And if you see in Geeland, it's not a factory, it's just a service world. Therefore, I'll use the term Juliana. Therefore, Juliana can consult with the chief internal auditor, the chief internal auditor, and develop some specific audit objective for the factory in Dealand, for the factory in Dealand. So I can say this can generally include a sustainability audit, whether they are minimizing the carbon footprint, comma, financial audit, whether the invoices are free from material misstatement, are free from material misstatement, material misstatements and errors. Operational audit, where the employees are working in accordance with company discipline. Full stop. Students, any questions here? Please let me know. Define the purpose of audit investigation, because that is very important, students. When you are developing an audit process, there should be some good objectives. You can't generally write it as usual. Okay, so students, I'll write down the next point. sources of evidence need to be documented. Because students, in the audit process, at the end of the day, you will be successful only if the sources are documented. If you do not have any proof or evidence for anything, then there will be an issue. So I can say the sources for all the transactions and events needs to be well documented and placed, comma. So I can continue here. So I can say, at present, we do not have such documentation. But in future, documentation is important. In order to have performance evaluation, take any legal actions or disciplinary action. Come on. So I will continue here. So I can say, Marco, with the support, Chief Internal Auditor, with the support of Chief Internal Auditor, could focus on development, development of some compulsory documentation such as invoices, comma, telephone conversation, because you can record that telephone, you can tell it's under recording. You would have seen customer service, sometimes they will ask you if the service is super, you put 1, if it is average 2, if it is bad 3. Mainly it is getting recorded, the telephone conversation, comma, the email conversation, all these are very, very important. A conversation and customer query. So these are very, very important. Okay, customer query can be documented. So I will further continue. Also, the documentation should not be done by an individual. And there needs to be a segregation of authority. There needs to be a segregation of authority so that the chances for committing fraud will be less. So that is very important. And then the final one I can say, as having deadlines and proper organizing. So students, we can continue the explanation here. So I can generally say is the audit process is generally carried once in a year, minimum it should be once in a year. So I can just write down, at present we are not sure, because they have not given any information, whether the company has a proper schedule for the audit reports and audit process. So I can continue here. Marco can work with the chief internal auditor in order to identify the current work schedule. So that they will be able to organize in a proper manner. Come on, I'll continue here. So I can generally say, however, the system needs to be updated frequently. The system needs to be updated frequently, because the company employees may get used to the system, and they can start to manipulate the process. Full stop. So students, I can generally say this is how we can develop an audit process. This answer is not a fixed answer, students, but this one is a fixed answer. I'll tell you, whenever you see something, please be careful. Define audit. Objective of the audit is purpose. It's very much purposeful. Now, students, here, since it's a new operation, experienced staff is coming. But if it is an operation for already what is there, no need experienced staff. Example, students, IT audit. We can have an IT audit on our application, everything, how it works. But we are using that app for a long period of time. For that, you can just mention recruit staff. That's more than enough. But sources of evidence, yes, but it should be specific evidence. Now, if you generally see for an app, it should be the credit card details, OTP codes, okay? The password, user ID, the real identification figures, where their address is almost matching with their address given in the registration, like that. And deadline is also a common point, but students, this is how we should be developing the answer. So students, any questions you have, please feel free to ask. Any questions you have, please feel free to ask. So students, if you're okay with this, you can put Y in the comment box. Y in the comment box. But I think you would have understood the answer is too much technical from your aspect. Very much technical from your aspect, that you should update it into a practical situation. And students, frankly speaking, you can pass this exam, students. This is very interesting paper, because you can just understand the case which is already there. And every day we are talking about this in our class. So students, I need to ask you some questions. So can you tell me what is our current share price? Can someone tell me what is our current share price?
Sub 40.
Correct. Correct. Current share price 14. What is our current selling price? Current selling price, hoverboard selling price.
What 5.8.
5.8. Thank you. Very good. How many minutes does a passenger use our hoverboard generally?
22.
22. Very good. Very good. Very good information. Okay, students, the next thing is who is our number one competitor? We do not have a competitor directly, but can you tell me one competitor who is very much close to us? DocBite, very good. Yeah. DocBike, very good. Very good. And they have a university proposal where they are training the university children to operate IT. So IT transformation can come. So I think it looks good. So students, now what I'm telling now is I think this week we did the basics, okay? So now I need to come to the planning now, students. So we will have classes as usual on Saturday, on Sunday and Friday. So students, from this week onwards, can we have the classes on Wednesday, Friday, Saturday? Wednesday, Friday, Saturday.
Okay.
Okay. So Wednesday we will have Pakistan time 9 o'clock, Indian time 9:30. Okay, students. Okay, the Friday time, the Pakistan time 9 o'clock, Indian time 9:30. So 3 days we are having now. And then students, I am going to increase the number of mocks also now because the basics are getting over. So another thing is today, if possible, can you just send me the ratio analysis work? Because I have never got the ratio analysis work. 9 p.m. Amit, 9 p.m. As okay, like sir. Friday. As like okay. Friday.
Okay, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. So hereafter, we will be working on 3 days and we will improve it. And students, I think I have emailed you a strategic level case study topics, example like the E3, P3, F3 topics. So students, can you just go through that areas and identify the topics which you are not good at so that we can at least do some revision, basic revision for the case, at least to improve your understanding. So students, any questions for today's session?
Sir, I have a question, not today's session, but pre-seen.
Tell me,
sir, how we can handle IT risk in an IT section? We are totally depend on network, relying out of. If network is out of service, our operation is stopped. Public network.
No, the main thing is we can step by step change our IT department into our own one, because at the moment even they have mentioned that the banks have clearly stated that the credit card is being phished, in other words, being hacked by people in some applications where they provide the data of the CVV number also. That is
no, sir, my question is this. Our customer is connected with us through an application, web application. If public, just a mobile phone network, public network is closed for some reason, then our operation is stopped. While in a particular area, mobile network is locked down, for example, specific area, and then our service.
I do understand, but frankly speaking, in a country where they have already operated for 5 years, I think it's mainly in the city regions. So we will not have that network down issue, generally, because it's in the city. But if it is in the village region, I can say yes. In a city near the malls, everything. So anyway, they will have a good, strong, stable connections. At least near the docking station.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that is fine. Any other questions, students?
Mr. Nifil, so you said the classes will be on Wednesday, Friday and Saturday.
Sunday.
Okay.
Today. Okay. Sunday. One day. So the now Sunday, that is Monday and Tuesday, you have 2 days. So yeah. I will give you long assignments. Fine with that.
Yeah. Sure. Okay.
So thank you, students. So I'll meet you on Wednesday this week. Okay. Take care. Good day. Good
thank night. You. Bye-bye. Okay.
Cyber risk management main topic, currency reaching. That main topic can you please start revising students, because it's very important. You need to start revising that area, because we will be doing that in the mock, but you start revising for the time you have, and please send me the ratio assignment by this.